Now that was a right old conflagration. Don't think they'll be chasing after us anytime soon. You certainly didn't leave them much of a port, though. I wonder if the town will ever recover.
How much did you tell them?
I had just started episode 2, Magilu's Fury, wherein the beautiful witch is captured and tortured by a demon most cruel!
I'm starting to see why they wanted to execute you. You seem busy.
We need more hands. We have to set our course and tie down the cargo. I've unfurled the sails. Does that not look safe to you?
Sure. As long as it doesn't come loose. Our destination is Logris. Set a course.
I'll do what I can, but this vessel really needs a bigger crew. We need to hire more men. Besides, if we keep sailing this way...
This is so hard to read.
Actually, you're holding it wrong. It's built to function even if the ship is rolling.
Huh. Velvet!
The heading's fine! Kid, what's your name?
Number 2.
Not that. Your real name. Surely you have one. Wanna hold it?
If that's an order...
I'm asking you what you want.
So you're ordering me to answer?
Right, right. You Malakim would destroy yourselves as long as it was an order, wouldn't you?
That is our purpose.
You really are tools. In that case, keep your mouth shut.
Cannon fire astern! Pirates!
That flag! It's got to be Aifread's pirate crew!
They've got a bead on us, folks! And in case you haven't noticed, we aren't really equipped for sea combat!
To land, then! We can fight them there!
Huh. Well, look at that. They really are a bunch of demons. That works in our favor.
You knowingly pick fights with demons? Must have a death wish.
You're in trouble now that we're on land.
Wipe them out, Number 2. That's an order.
Whoa there. We're not the one you'll be fighting.
It'll be me.
A Moloch?
No. I'm the Reaper.
Disruption! Hold up!
What is this guy?
A Moloch pirate?
A sword. Twin blades. No pendulum that I can see.
Let's go!
Slow down!
See this? Deception!
Slow down!
Join us.
Well, aren't you the impudent one?
Says the demon who torched Televis.
You knew about that?
I hope you realize we're doing you a favor. If you'd stayed on that course, you would have smashed right up against the gate of Vortigern.
You guys are headed for Midgand, aren't you? That means you're gonna have to go through the narrows up ahead. But the kingdom has a massive fortress there built to defend them, with a tremendous gate.
A fortress.
If this is true, we're in your debt.
We desire to pass through as well, but we lack the strength. I propose we form a partnership.
I'd be a fool to blindly trust the words of a pirate.
Do you really want to see the gate for yourself? We won't stop you. We'll even throw you a nice funeral if you like.
So what? We're allowed to refuse?
Your business is your business, and ours is ours. There's nothing more to say.
But First Mate, you can't go alone. We'll all come with you.
You'd only get in the way. Stick to the plan and focus on your duties aboard the Von Eltia.
What are you folks planning anyway?
Like I said, we're getting through that gate. If you're not helping us, then the conversation's over.
Is it possible to get through?
If the First Mate says he'll do it, he'll do it.
You sure put a lot of faith in him. He's a Moloch, isn't he?
That doesn't matter. He's got the captain's blessing, and that's enough for us.
Couldn't you ignore the narrows and just sail around?
Not now. We lost both our compass and several of our crew in an earlier attack.
Compass?
Huh.
But in the end, we're pirates. If someone blocks our way, we can't just fall back.
And that's what makes a pirate, huh?
Tragically, your favorite witch is neither a sailor nor a warrior. All she can really do is look on.
No argument there.
Is the Gate of Vortigern really something that impressive, Dial?
They've got a fortress and a patrolling fleet, but the gate is the real show. Even a battleship couldn't blast its way through that thing.
Is there no sea route that avoids the narrows?
There is, so to speak, but it's a long way out into the open sea. We just end up shipwrecked.
The pirates share our goal. I don't think we have any choice but to band together.
True enough. If forward lies destruction and backward lies doom, sideways is your only option!
And yet you don't feel like helping out.
I sure don't.
That Moloch isn't all he seems. Who knows what's up his sleeves?
The kid's a Moloch, too. Hey, boy, you sense anything?
We both have ulterior motives. In any case, let's go after him.
I know you probably won't listen to me, but you shouldn't get involved with Aifread's pirates. Aifread is the fiercest, most villainous pirate in all the seas. Every sailor trembles at his name.
For a demon, you're pretty wimpy.
Demon or not, scary is scary.
So this Aifread is that tough?
You bet. Rumor has it he's an unrepentant troublemaker and is as strong as an ogre. His gang are all fearless, wild rogues. They've turned the tables on the Royal Navy time and time again. And best of all is their ship, the Von Eltia. She's a legend that's traveled to distant lands across the sea.
Nice. Sounds like I'd get along with them just fine.
You seem to know an awful lot about them yourself.
Well, it's just that every sailor dreams of being as wild and free as Aifread and his pirate crew.
I guess.
Hey, I can dream, can't I? Demon or human or even lizard, we all got our fantasies.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
Don't waste my time.
Come on, really?
Well then, let's move on.
So, you've chosen to trust a pirate?
Not for a second. But if you're prepared to lend us the use of your ship and crew until we reach the capital, we'll help you.
I'll agree to those terms. But there's something I should tell you first. I bring ill fortune to all those around me. The Reaper's curse. I could flip this coin 1,000 times and still land on tails. Trying to get through the fort cost the lives of 5 good sailors. If you join up with me, I can't guarantee your safety.
Why would you go out of your way to warn us?
Even demons don't want to meet an unfair death, right? If you still want to come with me, just know the risks.
Works for me. I land on tails, I'll flip it to heads on my own.
Your name?
Velvet. This is number 2.
I'm Rokuro. A pleasure.
Aizen.
You've got a plan of attack, I'm sure. Let's hear it.
To put it bluntly, Vortigern is impregnable. It won't fall to an attack whether by sea or by land.
So, no plan?
Wait, what about both at once?
Exactly. First, we send in the Von Eltia to draw their fleet out of the Narrows. Then we slip inside and open the sea gate ourselves. The Von Eltia will then break away and rush back into the channel. We'll climb aboard and push through.
One slip and we're all as good as dead.
Then don't slip and we're not dead.
Walking with the Reaper, huh?
The plan is already in motion. Let's move. This cave leads to the fortress.
All these vines. They're too tangled to cut through.
I'm carrying some flint. Just burn through it.
Do you really think this is a good place for us to start a fire?
Normally, no. But we're also demons and Malachim. Get what I'm saying?
Yeah, we're not exactly normal ourselves.
Thank you.
The kid's awfully quiet. You think maybe there's something wrong with him?
Number two's always that way.
Stop that. Calling him by a number is cruel.
What's Rokuro mean?
Well, son number six, technically.
Same thing then.
Not even remotely. You all right, kid?
Why didn't you say something? If Aizen hadn't noticed in time, you'd be dead!
Because you ordered me to keep my mouth shut.
That's not what I meant! Why? Why would you do that?
Whoa, take it easy, Velvet.
Let me guess, kid. You were bound by an exorcist? I thought as much. The boy's will has been sealed away. Malakim have individual personalities, just like humans. But exorcists have developed methods to seal those personalities away, so they can use Malakim as uncomplaining tools.
Will he always be like this?
Can't say. I've never seen one escape the exorcist before.
Listen, kid. If you're ever in trouble, speak up, okay?
If I'm in trouble?
You said exorcists bind Malakim's free will.
Yeah. We've lived in this land a long time, and we're our own folk, just like humans. Only a small portion of humans, those with strong resonance, like the exorcists, were able to perceive our existence.
But the Advent changed that.
Now Malakim can be seen by ordinary people. We're being robbed of our free will and made into obedient tools. Humans praise Artorias for providing a miraculous new weapon against demons, but Malakim aren't mere objects.
Malakim aren't things?
They are. As far as Artorias is concerned, Malakim, demons, and humans are all nothing more than tools. Everything in service to his utopia of reason. That's all anyone is to him. Even my brother.
Thank you.
You'll be rust on my blade.
Let's go.
If you want to live, get out of my way. Thank you.